Happy Friday, Bears! It's me, Miss Katie. How are you today? Happy Friday. The weekend is almost here. Just almost here. We are so close. Okay, we've had a wonderful day so far. Thank you to you, those of you who joined us for our Zoom virtual field trip today. We went to a chocolate factory and learned where chocolate came from. Did you know it came inside a little nut? It was pretty cool. If you want to know more, I can send you the link. So, anyways, well, today I want to read this book that Chloe gifted our classroom with. It is called Parker Looks Up. Parker Looks Up. Let's see what's inside. Here we go. I hope I don't fall off my chair. Okay. Parker Curry loved to dance. Dressed in her favorite tutu, she imagined she was a dancing queen. Look at her. She does look like a dancing queen. But one rainy Tuesday, let's do it this way. There we go. But one rainy Tuesday, instead of going to dance class, Parker's mom said, "Let's go to the museum." "Ava too," Parker said. Parker loved visiting the museum, almost as much as she loved twirling and leaping in the air. Mom and her sister, Ava, buttoned up their jackets. "Have fun, girls. Bye, Dad." And off they went. Splashing and smiling and there's the museum. Surprise! Surprise! Gia, Parker's best friend, greeted them from the top of the museum steps. "Yay, it's Gia." Once inside, the friends hurried down a long hall, looking at the paintings all around them. This museum kind of makes me think of the Field Museum. Does it make you think of that too? They saw prancing horses, blooming flowers. Look at that. Beautiful. Well, that's like when we went to the art museum. A bushy mustache. A shiny jeweled necklace. Two peacocks with red eyes, and a basket of slimy fish. Ew, no slimy fish. And feathers, lots of brilliant feathers. "Hurry up, Ava." When Gia spotted a playroom, she raced ahead. Parker charged after her. "Explore! Let's make silly faces." After Gia stuck purple hair onto the easel and Parker added a pirate hat and sunglasses, it was time to go home. "Time to go, girls." Skipping down the hall, the girls spied a row of frilly white tutus. Parker raised her arms. Gia spun around and around and around. "Wait for me," Parker called, dancing after her friend, until... It always makes you wonder what's going to happen next when the page ends with the word until. She froze in her tracks, spellbound. Parker Curry looked up. A portrait of First Lady Michelle Obama loomed before her. She had rich brown skin just like Parker, and kind, familiar eyes that reminded Parker of her mother, her grandmother, her sister, and yes, even of herself. How could someone look so real and so magical all at the same time? Who is she? Parker's mother's voice filled the air, her words coming to rest squarely on Parker's tiny shoulders. Mother, lawyer, writer, caring hero, courageous, smart, inspirational, confident, dynamic, honest, advocate, volunteer, mentor, hopeful, friend, sister. She is a queen, Parker whispered, unable to look away, to move, to breathe. In that moment, Parker saw more than just a portrait. She saw a road before her with endless possibilities. Suddenly, Parker felt a small hand in hers. And the spell was broken. "Come look, Ava," she said, putting her arm around her little sister and standing tall. For Parker Curry was feeling powerful and strong, and even though she hadn't moved, inside she was dancing. The end. What a beautiful book. Okay. Well, that's it for today. That's it for this week. I hope you guys have a great weekend. Stay safe. Stay cool. If it's raining, stay dry. All right. And we will see you guys next week. I love you. I miss you. Bye.